हेलो टू एवरीवन, ग्रीटिंग्स टू ऑल एंड वी अप्रिशिएट द अटेंडेंस टुडे. सो लेट्स किक स्टार्ट आवर सेशन विद अ ग्रेट कोटेशन. दिस इज अ कोट बाय माइकल ए गर्बर. द की टू ग्रोइंग योर बिजनेस इज टू आइडेंटिफाई एंड फोकस ऑन योर निच दैट इज लार्ज इनफ टू सस्टेन योर बिजनेस एंड स्मॉल इनफ टू लेट यू बी सीन एज अ स्पेशलिस्ट. अ वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल द गेस्ट एंड डिग्निटरीज हियर. इन दिस कैपेसिटी एज योर होस्ट फॉर दिस वर्ल्ड वाइड वेबिनार ऑन निच क्लैरिटी, आई लक्ष्मी द होस्ट वुड लाइक टू टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू एक्सटेंड अ हार्टी ग्रीटिंग टू ईच एंड एवरी वन ऑफ यू. It gives me a great pleasure to extend a warm hello to each and every one of you gathered here today. It's a huge honor for us to have someone of this caliber here whose involvement on the topic of niche clarity adds so much value to it. Niche clarity refers to the precise definition and understanding of a specific market segment or area of expertise where a business or individual focuses their efforts. Achieving niche clarity involves identifying and targeting a distinct group with unique needs or interests, allowing for tailored strategies and messaging. This focused approach enhances relevance, positions one as an expert, and often leads to more effective and efficient engagement with target audience. Coming to a brief introduction of SEMS, SEMS Welfare Foundation, a registered non-profit organization, is dedicated to social impact across various sectors. We focus on education, particularly skill development and entrepreneurship. Through our initiative Digi Saksham, we have created training program in IT, finance, retail, and entrepreneurship impacting over 6,000 individuals. We are currently upskilling inmates in Haryana jail and collaborating with universities and colleges. We have also partnered with banks to place over 1,500 candidates in jobs. FemLeads, another SEMS initiative, empowers women through workshops and stories of successful female entrepreneurship. We conduct programs on digital literacy, marketing, and career development, reaching over 1,000 women across multiple states. This initiative recently reached a milestone of 100 women actively involved. In just a short time, SEMS has established itself as a force for positive change, equipping individuals with skills for employment and promoting women leadership in various industries. Now, let me take this wonderful occasion to publicly present and welcome Rathika Said, the keynote speaker for today's international webinar. Rathika Said is a certified law of attraction coach, NLP practitioner, and angel invocation expert, and her mission is to help people live a life of freedom, free will and choice using law of attraction, personal development and finance independence as a basic tool. There are many gems and diamonds in the world, and one of them is here today to help us build this event. With this note, I, Lakshmi, on behalf of SEMS Welfare Foundation, would like to give my heartiest welcome to Rathika Se with a huge round of applause for joining us today. Your presence.
Thank you, Lakshmi.
Thank you, Rathika, ma'am. Yeah. Your presence has added to the significance of this event, and we are genuinely honored to have you here. Once again, a very warm welcome to all the participants and dignitaries here, and also to our guest of honor, Rathika Seth, ma'am. We are looking forward for an informative and enjoyable event ahead. Now over to you, ma'am.
Thank you for such a lovely welcome. Thank you all of you who've joined us over here. And I hope I'm able to add some nuggets of knowledge to your queries. And before saying anything, I just want you to quickly chat with me and let me know, are you guys already into a profession or you're looking at starting something new? What is it that you're looking for today? Because niche is a very, it's a very vast subject. What happens is most of the times we know what we are good at. We have an idea what we are good at, but we are so confused in our head. We need validation, from others. We need validation from our friends, our family, or our colleagues. We just need to be told again and again and again, oh my God, you're good at this. And so many times, we start doing something in life and we have a complete shift after 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, realizing all that we've been doing throughout, we are not enjoying that anymore, isn't it? And so many times we realize that people had been complimenting us for things since the very beginning, but we used to laugh it off. So, for example, as a woman, if you were good at cooking a particular dish and everybody who came to your house told you, "Oh my God, I love this, what you cook." But for you, it was like, okay, no big deal. It's okay. I'm not such a great cook. Maybe you are. And maybe your niche lies in teaching people how to cook. So niche clarity is a very interesting subject. Most of the times when, I talk to people, we realize that niche is something which the more we understand what we are good at, the more we realize what we want to do in life. So I hope I'm going to simplify this for you. And the biggest problem we face is that, it's a Red Sea. Whatever we want to do, it's a huge ocean. So for example, I am into coaching. Now there are so many coaches there out there in the market. It's a ocean, right? But the minute I have my niche clear that okay, I want to target women or I want to target an X, kind of profile, and this is what I'm going to do. I am going to teach people how to have their niche clarity. For example, instead of saying I'm somebody who can, I'm a career coach, which is so broad. There are 20,000, 50,000 more career coaches who will be doing so many webinars every single day. But just saying that I'm a career coach, will you join my webinar today? If you don't know, what am I going to talk about? But the minute you know I'm going to talk about, say, niche clarity, you join the webinar because I am answering your pain point over there. So how do you start from scratch and yet stand apart is your niche. The more the more careful you are about choosing your niche, the more close-knit you are about choosing your niche, the wider your target becomes. You have more and more people coming to you the minute you are more and more specific. So one of the biggest mistakes what people make is they try to target a very large audience and they try to make their niche something which everybody wants. And that's the biggest red flag because there are too many players in the market. Whenever you're choosing a niche for yourself, go as, narrow it down as much as you can. Go as specific as you can and you will be able to grow your audience. Grow your target because then more and more people will come to you because people want a specific pain point to be answered always. Nobody wants generic, talks or people don't want generic answers to their questions. They want something solved. Whether you're selling a product, whether you're selling a service, whether whatever industry you may be, you have to be the medicine to somebody's pain point. And that's when people will come to you. So the mission here is to help you start your business from scratch and make you become a brand to reckon with. Okay, even if you're in a job right now, if you're a working professional also, always remember, have your niche very clear and you become a brand for yourself because that's where the world is going. Whether you change jobs, your clients will come running to you if you're good at what you do. Unless the vision should be to collectively empower every human being to get financial freedom. That's my vision. And that should be your vision as well if you're either starting off a new business, getting into something, and identifying your niche. Or you are somebody who's already into something wanting to upscale your niche. Irrespective, if your vision is to serve people, you will be on the right path. Now let's also talk about code of honors. So you, A, financial freedom. I'm sure if all of you are here trying to identify your niche, you want to be financially independent. And that's why you want to do something which you will be good at. 2, become a brand. 3, prioritize yourself. The minute you prioritize yourself and you want to do well for yourself, you will start thinking about people you're serving in your niche. You will want to make people happy. You will want to serve more and more people. Remain consistent. It's a journey. It's not a destination. So many times when we are talking about niche clarity, I must also tell you this, that as human beings, we start doing something which we feel is our niche and we go on doing something. And then suddenly with time, we change, our thought process changes, our likes and dislikes change, and we suddenly have another niche we are falling in love with. And last but not the least, service. Always back of your mind should be to serve people. On that note, let's get going with niche clarity. Before I start on the topic, let me just tell you my company is called Gratitude Concepts. And if all of you want your daily dose of inspiration, you can find me Gratitude Concepts by Ratika Seth. You can find me on Instagram, Facebook, or my podcast, Flight to Fulfillment, which is there on Apple and Spotify both. Now, let's play this magical experience with these 5 rules. A, play full out, be attentive, take notes. Whatever I'm talking, I'm sharing my screen so that you can take notes, but listen to me also. Listen to me because I'll be talking a lot more than what's written out there. So keep your pen and paper ready, keep taking notes, keep chatting, keep lighting up the comment box. Even if we don't go through it as I'm talking, I will be going through every comment later on. And if there's something which remains to be answered, I will get in touch with Sems and Lakshmi and I will give you an answer to that. So just keep lighting the comment box.
All right, those circles. Oh, cool.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, sure, right. Sure.
Yeah. And do your daily affirmations, everybody. Always be positive. Do your daily affirmations. Say you can do it, you will do it, and you must do it. And be honest, be consistent. So on that note, let's start. The fundamentals. Choose a niche which has a demand. Okay, don't choose something where you'll say, no, I love this, so I want everybody else to love this. Something has to have a demand. Okay, identify your audience. And again, go as specific as you can. I've mentioned here the age, the interest, the income level of your audience. But more than that, go more specific. Just think what your audience wants and how are you helping your audience? What is it that you are going to be bringing on the table that will tell somebody that, listen, this is the person I want to go ahead with. This is the product I want to buy. This is the service I want to take. Set your goals long term and short term. If you're, you know, getting into your niche clarity to start something, have your goals clear. What you want to achieve in the next 3 months, in the next 6 months, in the next 1 year. And then follow your niche accordingly. Make your vision board. Write down everything. Make pictures. Whatever it is that you want to achieve should be in front of you every day. Okay? And that's when you will be able to specifically go on your niche also. I must tell you something as we go on with this webinar today. I will be helping you, okay? I will be helping you identify your niche right here as we are speaking right now, because I will be taking you through the Japanese concept of Ikigai, which is finding your life purpose, finding your niche, finding your why. So keep your pen and paper ready, because you will do this exercise, and I want by the end of the webinar, any one of you who's confused about your niche should have some clarity. And then you can, of course, ponder over it after the webinar and, you know, fine tune it even more. But do that as we speak. Do all the exercises as we speak and take all your decisions which are backed by data and research. You know, the best way of identifying your niche and following up, you know, with your niche is also looking up to people who are there in your niche, following their journey, studying their journey. It will help you make a roadmap for yourself. Are you all resonating with me here? Should we go ahead? So, niche is of 4 kinds: personal, your hobbies, your art and craft, your skill sets, your services, your products, or you can get into educational niche, which can be something what I do, coaching, counseling, training, therapy. You can get into financial niche, making money, investing money, managing money, wealth management, career counseling, You can teach people how to make money through affiliate marketing, through passive income. Then we get into the basic materialistic things, all products. So basically, any niche is categorized into these four categories. Identify which category you belong to. Where do you want to go? You want to just sell a product which you have. You want to educate people, get into coaching, counseling. You want to get into the financial segment. Or you have a hobby which you want to take it up as a business. You have a skill set which you know, which you want to take it up as a business. Micro niche. What is micro niche? Like I told you, I am, you know, when I say I'm a coach, I specify I am coaching people to get this particular objective. So the more targeted you are to identify your micro niche, the faster you will grow. The more specific your results will be. So if you're somebody, you know, even if you're teaching yoga, for example, hypothetically speaking, you can have your micro niche that you teach a particular form of yoga to a particular age group or a particular gender. If you're, you know, whatever niche, even if you're a career counselor, have a micro niche saying that your target is students who are studying for IT or students who are studying for something else. Identify your micro niche, because then people will specifically come to you. If you're teaching students, school going students, your micro niche can be an age group. You're only teaching the 11th standard and 12th standard and only teaching science. So that becomes your micro niche. Identifying your micro niche will also help you focus better, because you will not be running helter skelter ki, oh my God, achha, main toh, I can only do this. Now let me find out somebody who wants my service. That will not happen. You will be focused that, okay, this is my target audience. So now let me, you know, just even your advertising will be focused on that target. Whatever, even your social media, you will focus on that target. So now you will have a target audience which is specific to what you want to do. Even if it's a product you're selling, you know the age group, you know the category, you know the income level, you know exactly how to target them, where to advertise, what to do. And the minute you are specialized, the minute, you know, you have your micro niche, that means you're specialized into something. And the minute you have a speciality, you get a stamp of confirmation and your competition reduces. So if you're a doctor, you know, you say you're a cardiologist, then you know that only people with heart diseases are going to come to you, and your competition reduces because, you know, a neuro person is no longer your competition, or your GP is no longer your competition. So any niche, pick up any niche whatsoever. The minute you have your stamp of specialization that, okay, you are the authority on this particular thing, this particular topic, or this particular product of yours is solving this pain point, your competition also reduces, because most of the people are, like I said, swimming in the red ocean. Not too many people are specific enough to come to the blue side. Not many people say that, okay, we are just, you know, satisfied with this blue side of the water. We don't want to go deep into the red side. No, people want to swim all over. So the minute you are specific, you are creating a chance to excel much faster. Let's get into categories. Okay, personal. All of you who have a skill set, if I've missed out any, these are very few, but write down your skill set here. Cooking, painting, music, yoga, Zumba, material arts, martial arts, dance forms, designing, stitching, sculpting, swimming, sports and games. So many, you know, hobbies. And today's day and age, the best part is we are living in times where anything we do can become our niche, and anything we do, we can make money. How many of us could have thought 10 years down that people would become influencers and make millions? People would become YouTubers and make millions. Did anybody ever think? No, but it happened. And in today's day and age, whatever you are good at, anything you are good at, you can make money. The only thing is you have to present yourself in the right manner. You have to brand yourself in the right manner. Correct? Anything. People do the weirdest of things and they make money. And then others wake up realizing, oh my God, I never thought of this. I never thought I could do this. And then you're like, I am better at this. I know so many things. I can do this. I can do this. Why did it not strike me that I could make money doing this? But today you can make money doing whatever. So all of you who want the clarity on your niche, you are here today. Just keep writing down anything and everything you are good at. And I will tell you why a little bit later. So start writing whatever you are good at. Educational. Niche, business, career, relationship, life, health and wellness, mindfulness, soft skills, language, parenting. So again, your niche should not be a broad niche. Don't say I'm a coach. Everybody is a coach. Everybody can coach. I can coach. If you have any experience in life, which you do, depending on whatever age you are in, you can coach too. Idea is, again, your micro niche. So instead of saying I'm a life coach, say I'm a life coach helping people resolve their relationship issues. Or I'm a health and wellness coach helping people overcome diabetes, or helping people lose weight, or helping, you know, people post 40 lose weight. Go as specific as you want to. Any of these niches. Again, pick and choose. The world's your oyster. Financial, banking and investment, wealth management, cryptocurrency, insurance, venture capitalist, stock marketing, real estate, any other niche you can think of in this, please go ahead, please write it down for yourself. So many people are getting into wealth management these days. I mean, you know, on one hand, I have clients coming and saying, oh, I really want to make money. And on the other hand, you have people saying that I have so much of money, I don't know what to do with it. And so you have people who are into wealth management, telling people how they should use their money, how they should convert their existing money into a legacy forward, going forward. So material is all products. You can get into retail. You can get into e-commerce, dropshipping, affiliate marketing. You can get into barters, you can get into pickup and delivery, whatever it may be. Again, even if you're getting into e-commerce, just don't have a website which will have all products under one roof, which people love to do. Okay, this is one website. Yahan aapko kapde bhi mil jayenge, aapko jewelry bhi mil jayegi, aapko ye bhi mil jayega, wo bhi mil jayega. Be specific, okay? So even if you're getting into e-commerce, you say, if you're getting into, you know, say sustainability, then have only organic products as a part of it. And say this is a website for sustainable living. If you're getting into clothing, identify you want to get into formals or semi-formals, or what is your specialty going to be? Are you going to be, you know, doing customized designing for people, or are you going to be selling to a particular size of people? Whatever it is, choose your niche. Accordingly, choose something where you can really target your audience by narrowing it down as much as you can. So, how do we validate your micro niche? Now, I've spoken, I've given you enough ideas about what all you should be doing. Always remember, your micro niche has to be specific. It's called the SMART way. S-M-A-R-T. Specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound. Specific means it should solve a specific problem. It should solve a specific pain point of a customer, whoever your customer is. It should be measurable. It should be able to make you money. No point choosing a niche which cannot make you money, isn't it? It should be achievable. It should be achievable within a specific amount of time. So whatever niche you're choosing, don't choose something which is going to take forever. So imagine you're starting today and you say, okay, you know, I am confident this thing will do well, if not today, after 10 years down the line. Who's seen 10 years of your life? Attract a specific target and get into a micro niche which is very, very achievable at this point in time. In a short point in time. You can say that, okay, I know I'm going to start today. In 6 months, I know where I'll be. Or in 1 year, I know where I'll be. Point taken. Go ahead. Do it. That much time everybody needs. But don't get into something which will take forever, where even you don't know how much time it will take. It should be realistic. It should have a potential to grow. It should not be something which is now coming down. We are all moving forward. Technology is changing every day. Whoever in this world would have thought about AI happening? If ask somebody 20 years back, who thought about things which have happened today? No one. So whatever niche you choose, you have to choose a niche which has a rising potential, because ultimately you have to grow your business. It is not only about, you know, it's not that you have something in your head. It's not an ego thinking, I need to do this. Bas kar liya. I want to have a website. See, I have my own website. Now finished. Now I'm not interested. No, na. Everybody wants to grow. So choose a niche which has a potential where you will grow. T, time bound, as I said, has to happen in a particular time frame. Cannot just be lingering on and on and on with it. So be smart. Validate your niche and identify these 5 steps. If these 5 steps are tick marked, you're on the right path. If it's solving a pain point, if it's making you money, if it's attracting your target audience, if it has the potential to grow, and if it is going to happen in a particular period of time, you are on the right path. So these are the ways to validate your micro niche. Now let's come to Ikigai. Ikigai is a Japanese concept. It's a very, very, very well-known concept. And this actually helps you identify what you want to do in the best possible manner. And in fact, I don't know, you know, how many of you have young growing children. If you have young growing children, if you have your nephews and nieces, please understand this concept and start teaching this concept to the younger generations, because it will help them get so much of focus and clarity. Today, children have so many options that ask somebody in their 9th or 10th. You know, at my time when we used to be asked, what do you want to become? We just had 3, 4, 5 things. Okay, depending on how good we were in our studies. All the smartest ones wanted to become doctors and engineers. Somebody like me who really did not want to study beyond a point, I said I want to become a fashion designer. It was the in thing for women at that point in time. So our times, things were very, very, you know, very, very few options we have. But now people have so many options that even a kid can get confused, because everybody wants to do everything. So share this concept with your children, with your nephews, nieces, the younger generation, with your friends who are confused. This will not only help you, this will help everybody else. Now, Ikigai is based upon 4 pillars. Okay, now keep your pen and paper ready here. You will be writing down, because I am going to pause after every pillar. I will give you a 2-minute pause, and I want you to come and, you know, have this chat box buzzing for me saying that, okay, we wrote down something, write down. First, what you love to do, write down. And it can be anything, okay? Write down anything you love to do. Even if you love to talk, write down talking. Maybe you will become a good public speaker one day. Write down. And just think about everything which you can do 24/7, 365 days in a year. Okay, I have one poet coming up. Good, great. So if you love to write poems, great. Teaching, communicating, computing, excellent. Everything. So all, remember, what you love to do is something which you can do 365 days in a year, 24/7. So ask me to talk about my subject. Wake me up at 3 o'clock in the morning and say, listen, Ratika, tell me this. I will love to tell you that. I will love to talk. I will talk about my subject then. So write everything you love to do to the extent that that's priority number one. Yes, lovely Priya, listening to music is a great, great, great thing. You love to do it. Great. Awesome. Write down everything you love to do. And as many things as you write down, the further we go, it will become, you know, more interesting for you to figure out your own niche. You will be, by the end of these 4 steps, I'm telling you, so many of you are going to get clarity on what maybe you can do in life. Traveling and helping others, Anjali, excellent. I love traveling too. And I love helping others too. Maybe you can become a travel coach.
Yes, ma'am.
Let's see. Let's go ahead. So if all of you have written what you love to do, now start writing, make another column saying what you are good at. Now let me tell you this. Here, when I say what you are good at, does not mean only the skill set you have professionally. No. That please mention. Okay, if you've taken, you know, you have certain skill sets which you've, you know, taken courses on, or you have an expertise, please mention all those. But besides those, also mention what you're good at, what you've never thought. Like I, you know, when I started this particular webinar, remember I spoke about people complimenting us in our lives, which we never take seriously. But in the long run, we are good at that. So even if you have friends, there are so many times, you know, when you are a wonderful listener to your friends, you know, your friends come and share their deepest secrets with you. And they love to talk to you. They just love to share everything because they know that sharing something with you, whatever suggestion they get, they take it very seriously. And they love your viewpoint. They love your reactions. Write down. If you're a good listener, write down, I'm a good listener. If you speak well, write down, you speak well. Whatever it is, yes, controlling emotions, excellent. Write it down because maybe you can help people do that also. Write it down. What you love to do, what you're good at. All the compliments you've got throughout your life till now. Think, write all those down. That, oh, I was good at this. I used to sing well also. Aray, this one used to compliment me at this. Write it down. Whatever compliments you've got, write it down. You're good at doing makeup, please write down that also. You're good at dressing up, write down that also. Teaching, analyst, listener, counseling, advising, excellent Piyush, excellent. So if all that is in place, let's go to the third one. What you get paid for. Now between one and two, what you love to do and what you're good at. Can you find something in common which will pay you also? Okay? Something you love to do and something you're good at. Some commonality, find a common link. Or write down something from, you know, category one, something from category two, whatever it is that will help you make money. Excellent, Priya. Teaching, done. So teaching, what? Have you written down what you're good at? If you're good at teaching, is it a particular subject you're good at? A language you're good at? I mean, if you're not good at maths, you cannot be teaching maths, right? You have to be good at whatever you're teaching. So, and it should be something you love to do and you're good at. Excellent, investing money, great. And you will get paid for it because you can teach people how to invest money. Okay, and what the world needs. That's point number four, because we are all born for a particular reason. When we say that, you know, when we talk about life purpose, you like to teach maths, Priya? Excellent. Okay, done. Maths teacher, here we have one. And I used to flunk always. But coming back to it, whatever the world needs is a very, very important aspect of choosing your niche, because your life purpose or something which you will really do well in is not complete till you are serving the world in whatever form. So even if you are a wedding planner, okay, I'll give you a very small example. Like, you know, I have Sana saying over here, she likes editing videos and photos. So the world needs this, right? The world need, you can make money from it because the world needs it. We need good photographers. We need good videographers. So somebody, you know, who's fond of singing. If you are a good singer, you are contributing to the world. Maybe you collaborate with other musicians tomorrow and come out with your own album. And you know, if you are a good, like, you know, earlier in the conversation, I had one gentleman saying poems. If you are a good poet, maybe your lyrics can inspire somebody. So the world needs it. Whatever it is that the world needs has to be, will come out from these three categories which you've written down right now. This is your self-introspection. You have to think very carefully what you love to do, what you're good at, what you get paid for, and what the world needs, right? And that's the concept of Ikigai for all of you. So what you love to do is your passion, correct? What you're good at is your skill. What the world needs is your mission, and what you get paid for is your profession. So once you have a common thing between the passion, the skill, the profession and the mission, you will reach your Ikigai. That is how you can come up with your niche. That is how you can get your niche clarity. How many of you had a bulb on moment today with me? At least something, some nugget I told you which was worth listening to. Please at least give me some chats coming in the chat box that yes, some clarity you got on what niche you wanted. Because this is a great way of identifying your niche. This is how I identified my niche as well. Because it's my passion. It's my passion to, you know, talk about life enhancement. I love to talk about life enhancement. I love to talk about the law of attraction because I have believed in the law of attraction, law of manifestation myself. And I love to see people happy. I love to help people. So that was my passion. And yes, my skill was that I could communicate, I could talk, I had the confidence to talk. And then I, of course, upgraded my skills by doing professional courses, which all of you, again, just a little bit of advice coming your way. Never stop learning, even if you have identified your niche, even if you start growing, if you start your business, please remember you have to continue to upscale and upgrade to consistently achieve in life. As human beings, we are always breathing, and that is why we are alive. So the minute we stop listening, the line goes flat like this, like they show it in movies on the screen, that gone, the person's gone. That's your you know, your future is gone the minute the line goes like this, because you've stopped learning, you've stopped upgrading yourself in life. So how many of you have got some clarity? Let me know something. That was my niche clarity. Business analyst is the answer I got. Perfect. Because Piyush, you know if you're skilled at it, go ahead. This is your niche. Get into this. You have to upgrade. Take some, you know, some courses. Go ahead. Do those. Learn. Anjali, consultancy. Excellent. Anjali, you should have your, you know, you should go deeper into this. What kind of consultancy? Go deeper. See, there are so many consultants. If you were to go to anybody today saying that, hello, my name is Anjali Gupta, I'm a consultant. And then people would have this reaction. Okay. So, but the minute you go specific and say, this is what I can consult you on. And this is what my consultancy is going to bring on the table for you. You will have people coming to you. You will not have to go to people. They will start coming to you. Health consultant. Perfect. Go even narrower. Go even narrower. Trust me, Anjali. Trust me. Go even narrower. What part of health are you consulting on? How many of us go to, you know, general physicians today for something major? We don't. We go to specialized doctors. If I have an eye problem, I'll go to an eye person. I have a skin problem, I go to a dermatologist. I, whatever problem I have, I go to a specific doctor, correct? That's what all of us do. A general GP, we only go for a random cough and cold. Ki theek hai, abhi aur kahin, I don't want to waste time. Just get some viral medicine from this guy. That's all. So go more specific. Health, what part of health? Are you going to target women? Are you going to target men? Are you going to target children? Are you going to target a particular age group? That I am, see, excellent. Anjali, are you realizing you are going deeper and deeper into this? So if you are a, if you can do a gyno and skin consultancy, what is the age group you want to target?
Ma'am, every age group, like ma'am, gyno is, I think it is trending in India. Most of the women are facing breast cancer and PCODs, PCOs, these kind of problems. So ma'am, they need a proper consultancy because there are a lot of doctors, they are misleading all the women about what problem
so
you are
what
having.
If you were, what if you were to call yourself a health specialist for PCOD and PCOS?
Yes,
don't
ma'am.
You think more people will come to you then?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that is what I'm trying to say. It's an excellent topic. It's an excellent thing you mentioned here, and you rightly said that people don't know who to go to because there are so many people misleading you today. So many,
yes, ma'am,
doctors, so many people in the medical fraternity misleading you. So
yes,
if
ma'am,
you were to, if you were to start your business today, if you were to say that, okay, my name is Anjali Gupta and I am a, you know, health consultant specializing in PCOD and PCOS for women, you will have people, you will have women coming to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Correct? So that is what I mean. Go deeper and deeper into your niche and then launch yourself.
Yeah.
Don't be in that red sea. Come to the blue ocean. The lesser, you know, the more micro you go, the lesser competition you have. The lesser competition you have, the more people you have coming to you. And you'll be able to make a name for yourself much faster. See, even if you know a lot of things, okay, now let me just answer. I'm sure a lot of people will have this question over here. Even if you, now you know that you can you know, consult, give consultancy on skin also. You are saying ki aap, you know, you can be a gyno also. Don't, you can do that later stage. Start with a specific need. Start making customers first. Whatever your, anybody here, whatever your niche is, whatever you're getting into, start making customers first. The minute you make customers, then expand. And then say, okay, this, you have already established yourself as this, and then say that, okay, now this is something else which I'm also doing, just by the way. So what will happen is, A, people who've already been with you, for example, Anjali, people start coming to you for PCOD and PCOS. They're
yes,
already your clients. And then after 1 year down the line, you say, oh, you know, to those people, by the way, I do this also. They will be the ones who will come to you. Plus, you will have others coming to you, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So that's what niche clarity is about.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I am already connecting with lots of doctors. Which are related to the particular topic, like ma'am, dermatologist and gynecologist. They are like, I'm like totally connected with them.
Huh, but Anjali, choose. Again, I'm saying gyne or derm. Dono mein se pehle ek choose karo. Who you want?
Ma'am, I want both. Ma'am, both are like,
you
I'm
want
passionate
the
about. Yes, ma'am.
But listen, okay, you go to have a meal in a restaurant, you've taken buffet mein se sara khana. मुंह में पहले एक ही चीज डालोगे ना, और यू विल पुट एवरीथिंग टुगेदर इन योर माउथ. डोंट डू दैट. स्टार्ट विद वन थिंग फर्स्ट. स्टार्ट विद वन थिंग एंड देन गो अप, गो टू द अदर. आई एम टेलिंग यू, यू मे बी गुड एट 20 मोर थिंग्स इन द सेम फ्रेटर्निटी, बट स्टार्ट समवेयर वेयर यू विल बी अ सक्सेस फर्स्ट. एंड वंस यू स्टार्ट सीइंग योर सक्सेस, देन गो फर्दर.
यस मैम.
वेल, दैट्स ऑल फॉर नाउ. I'm open to any more questions coming my way. Anybody else wants to know anything?
So I request anyone here to have.
Yes, I think Mr.
Gandhi. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Please proceed with your questions.
Madam, I want to ask about the niche, changing niche. In the beginning, I was a businessman doing the cloth business. I was selling the cloth. Then my hobby changes to I should study, and I did engineering, and after engineering I thought I should serve the country. I served Bhel Haridwar and HL Lucknow for 37 years. Now my niche is going again back to my cloth business. What should I do if my niche is changing?
No, see, the niche can change, like I said in the beginning also. As time passes, our likes and dislikes change, so our niche can change. But you know, again, I would like to say, you think of what, you know, why is this happening? Is it for a reason that you are going back to the cloth business, or is it because you realize you that
because
is what
I need
you love
money.
The most,
huh? I need money. After retirement, I don't get pension, so I need money. And in the beginning, I was doing business for cloth, so I was getting the profit of the cloth business.
But you can no, but that is not so. You cannot choose your niche only if you want to choose a correct niche. Then it is not only money. It has to solve all the three other things also. Is it your passion? Do you love doing it?
My passion is to write poems. I have written about 300 poems.
And okay, let's come to your poems. What subject do you write on?
Any subject. Shringar, then Veerras, any poem.
Okay. So do you think you can, you know, you can, you know how, you can tell people how to write poems, the technical aspects of writing a poem? You know, how do you write a good poem? What is it that takes to make a good poem? You have to have passion, for example. You have to have passion for a subject you're writing on. You have to have knowledge. You have to be able to rhyme words. So many things which go into writing a poem. If that is your passion, if your passion is writing a poem, why do you not, side by side, I'm not saying do only this, while you're doing your other cloth business or any other thing you're getting into, why don't you side by side do something online to do with poems? Or if you are so fond of poems, then I'm sure you're also fond of listening to poems, not only writing, right? If you're a poet.
Yeah.
Maybe you can create a network of poets together.
Yeah. We have got a network.
Yeah, so your community can grow like that. See, your niche has to be something you are really fond of doing. Doing something just to make money is not your, then you cannot call it your passion. It's not your niche. That's just a business you're doing, like so many of us.
Okay. Thank you, madam. Thank you.
How can a small firm effectively compete in a niche market dominated by larger players? Well, a small firm, Piyush, you have to have, a certain answers in place. What is the value you offer to your customer? Okay. So what is the value addition that you are giving? Every market has large players. Coaching has, I said, 20,000 coaches at one single point in time. Even if somebody who gets into food business, I open a restaurant today, there are so many restaurants already there. So the you will always have, see, if you're getting into something which has a lot of players, at least one thing is sorted out for you, that you're getting into a niche which, you know, like I said, the smart process, you know, this is something which will make you money. You know something that this the world wants. That's why it's doing well. So if you to compete in a niche market dominated by players, you need to have your USP or UVP, unique value proposition. One is your unique selling point, which is your USP, that okay, this is our USP, hum aise karte. Ek hota hai unique value proposition, that you have your USP. Now with that USP, what value can you offer to people, that they come to you, that they try your product? Is it a product, Piyush? Can I ask you, what is your niche? What is the market? Is it a product? Is it retail or is it education? What are you into?
Hello.
Education. Great. So a lot of people in the education market. Yes, I agree. But again, you know, this is something where you can really go micro, if you know what I mean. You can actually specify the age group of people, the language, the age group, everything, and go specific. See, there are too many players in the education, but a lot of them are just generally throwing ads here and there and trying to, you know, create a name for themselves. Even
excuse me, ma'am, you're on mute. Ratika, ma'am.
Okay, when did I go on mute? Piyush, have you just missed everything I said? Hello, Piyush, have you just missed everything I said?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So, I was saying that there are a lot of players in the education segment. Yes. But go specific on your niche. Because education is specifically commerce subject. Accounting. So, excellent. No. So, accounting. You want to teach accounting to what age group of people?
Or like 18 to 22.
So, you are narrowing it down. So, now you will not have a problem. Trust me. Go on. Make a course. Go on, go ahead, do it. Just say that, okay, my name is so-and-so and I specialize in accounting. Maybe if there's some speciality which you have, please mention that also. That I specialize in teaching this to an age group of 18 to 22 so that they can achieve this. Maybe they can go ahead and give their accounting, whatever their exams may be after that age group. I don't know, whatever. Because you have a lot of players, I agree, but then that's half your things solved here on this ikigai, na? Because it will make you money and it is solving a purpose. So, though to aapka tick mark waise hi ho gaya hai. And I'm sure you're skilled at it and it's your passion. So, just go micro. Just see ki how small can you go. You know, don't get scared. A lot of people get scared thinking ki, arre, if we just keep going micro, humare paas aayega kaun? You will get the maximum number of people, because then people will know that, okay, this is specifically somebody who wants this will come to you, and then grow, then expand later on. Then teach people whatever, get into your business management, everything, or tell people that, okay, now that guys, you know how to do this, by the way, upgrade and come to my, you know, the next level of my coaching where I also teach this, so that you can combine these two things together and make a career for yourself. Take that route then.
Okay. So, once again, I express my gratitude and thanks to Ratika ma'am for sparing time from her hectic schedule to impart information to us. We are speechless by your invaluable presence at this session. You provided in-depth analysis of the subject and shared some fascinating information. We shall bide our time for further such workshops in order to advance both our personal and collective knowledge. Additionally, I want to thank everyone in the attentive audience for their smart questions and active involvement. This event is considerably more meaningful because of your participation.